Oh, yeah. Oh, my gosh. Here we are. Day two. How exciting. I hope everybody was able to join us earlier for our coffee chat. That was a lot of fun. That coffee chat was a good time. That was tons of fun. If you did miss it, you can go catch it on our Facebook page there. So it was fun. Just a good see, like, hear from the product team themselves to see what's the roadmap, you know, what do we do? And when you share all your awesome feedback, all that cool stuff. So really awesome stuff there. But okay, I see everyone coming in. Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to jam out there for a second. So first of all, I just want to welcome everybody here. I'm going to be leading this session today. I'm super excited. I love this webinar. This is a really awesome topic that I love. But we're also going to have Bonnie and Alum in the background getting questions. So if you start seeing them replying back there, that's where they're doing hard at work, getting all those questions answered, that we will try to get as much as we possibly can. I'm just going to let the music kind of fade out a little bit in here while I go through these slides. So what we're here today for is creating a sales workflow, which, again, one of my favorite topics of all time, because it really brings in the whole Travefy product and you get to see how to use every part along the way of your sales workflow. Super awesome. But before I do jump into all that, there's a couple things that I always like to share here. First one, get training camp certified. So some of you actually might be hitting it right now, because this would be, so it's attending 5 or more webinars. I could be wrong, but I think this is the 5th official webinar that you would be joining to count. So it is important to note 2 things. So one, if you are unable to actually attend at the time, you can watch the recording. So you just have to watch the recording before March 20th. So I believe that's like next month. You get the weekend basically to catch up and watch everything. And we can see that. We can see when you do watch it and all that good stuff. So you'll have until then. And then on Friday, we'll send out, or by Friday next week, we'll send out all the certification and all that good stuff. The other thing that's really important to note about certification, though, as well, is that not all of them count, but the majority of them do. It's really only the Facebook Lives. Facebook Lives, unfortunately, just don't count, because we can't see who's attending those as easily. So that's why. But if you go to our webpage, if you go to trainingcamp.travefy.com, click on the FAQ at the top, and you'll see a full list of all the ones that do count. This one counts. So really cool. So again, majority of them do, but questions about that, just let us know. Another thing here, of course, we're recording this because, again, you know, this is going to count towards certification if you or somebody else comes in and watches this over the weekend or over this week. So these all are recorded and you can see all of them right after. So if you do have to hop off during this, you can actually just go onto that the trainingcamp.travefy.com and you'll be able to watch it. It might take like 5 minutes after we get done, but it's up right away. So cool thing there. The other thing, you probably already know about this by now, but we started something new this year where we're doing bonus encore sessions. So these are a really great way to just elevate it to the next level, because there's just so much we could talk about. So we decided to do these special Facebook Live sessions at the end of each day. Today's is my top Travefy tips and tricks, which I am super excited for. There's some good stuff in there. So check that out at 4 p.m. Central. And you can just go to our Facebook page. It'll be on there. You can also watch Bonnie's from yesterday. She did one on creating a landing page, which I will talk a little bit about today, but not as in-depth as she went. So do check that out. And then tomorrow, it'll be our good pal Scott's doing 10 tips to maximize your Travefy library. So check those out. They are really, really awesome. So those are going to be fun. Last thing that I want to note, and Bonnie's in the background, I could see her here. We are going to be doing Travel Trivia Happy Hour. Oh, yes. It's going to be so much fun. So when we're finished with everything, which is on Thursday, and it's going to be here before we know it probably, is we are going to wrap up with Travel Trivia Happy Hour, where you can actually win some prizes and just have a ton of fun. You know, grab your favorite drink, get on, you know, we'll do Zoom meetings so we can see everybody, we can chat. It's really awesome. So it's going to be a good time. So join us for that. And you can also register for that, of course, on trainingcamp.travefy.com. But okay. So I'm done with my spiels. So now I want to talk about what we're all here for today, is we want to talk about a sales workflow in Travefy. Now, I'm going to show this slide before I dive in, and I'm going to keep coming back to this slide because what we're going to do is we are going through an entire process of using Travefy's tools in the sales workflow. So we're actually going to start off with the marketing side. Usually, you know, you'll be doing marketing and, you know, you're doing that landing page and then, you know, using the website, people are going to come to that and they're getting interested. So we'll start off with that. And then from the marketing side, you have where you're starting to capture some leads. And that's where the forms comes in. So I'm then going to show you, you know, how can you use the forms to capture these new leads? Then the third part of that is organizing those leads. So once those leads come in, what are you doing to make sure you stay on top of them, reach out, all that good stuff. So then we'll talk about how to organize those with our CRM. And then after that, you have the part where you send them a proposal. So then we're going to talk about how to do the proposal. What does that proposal workflow look like for that new client? And then what does it look like once they approve it and it's converted into an itinerary? And then in between that, you might have some like credit card authorization forms that they fill out, things like that. So we'll talk about all of that. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to go through all of these pieces in the order that they would normally be going. So that's why I love this. It's really cool because you'll get to see how this works. Now, it might feel like too that I'm going to jump around a little bit and you might be like, whoa, this is a lot. Similar to the webinar I did yesterday, it always feels like so much. I cram in a lot. So just wanted to let you know that our support team is ready to help. So if there's anything you see here today that you're like, oh, I really want some more information on that. Well, we do have a lot of videos available that you can go check out at travefy.com/support, but also reach out to our support team or live chat in your account. And we can help answer those questions as well. And I do hope to get through some Q&A at the end. We won't be able to get to every question, but I'll do my best to do a lot of questions at the end here. So put those in the Q&A panel in there as well so we can get those answered for you. Now, okay, this is the second part I always like to show. Why did we come up with this specific webinar of a sales workflow? Well, when we did our annual survey last year, 72% of Travefy users reported that Travefy helped them grow their business or close more sales. The reason why that is the way it is because of a sales workflow like I'm going to show you. So I always love showing this number. And in fact, I'm sure this is going to jump up after we figure out our, because we've added so many more features and enhancements over the past year that when we get our annual survey done this year, I bet this number grows. It's so awesome. And that's what our team has really been focusing on is how can Travefy be an all-in-one place for you? So you're going to see that here today. So I'm going to go back to this slide now. And again, I'm going to keep coming back to this so that way it's easy to follow along in the process that I'm going through. So, okay, let me take a drink of water and then we will get started here. Okay, are you all ready? Here we go. Okay, so the first thing, marketing. So when you're doing the marketing stuff, you're probably like, oh my gosh, how do I do marketing in Travefy? Well, we have what's called the website or landing page builder. And by the way, this is all part of your Travefy subscription. So you have access to all of these things I'm going over as well, which is awesome. But now, since we're going to start in the website side, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come into my account here. So here you can see my account. Now to access your website and landing page builder, you are just going to click on your name in the top right-hand corner, and then you are going to click website. So that's what you're going to do. Now, we will have a more in-depth webinar on Thursday on how to build a website, but one thing I wanted to focus on today is just talking about the landing page side. So again, if you saw Bonnie's encore yesterday on Facebook Live, she went over how you can use a landing page, and really what a landing page is it's just a one single one-pager that has one purpose. So maybe you're marketing a trip or a service, a river cruise, whatever it might be. In this example that I'm going to go through, I am trying to promote sending people to Los Cabos. So I'm trying to promote Cabos as a destination and then maybe just spotlight a couple resorts that I tend to work with just to show new leads. So how you can do this is if you click down at the top here, you can build as many pages as you want, which means that you can have, you know, one website that has multiple pages. But these can also be, of course, those standalone pages, which we refer to as landing pages. So in this landing page, I already started putting this together, but I made it extremely simple. And how you do put together these, a website or a landing page, is really simple. All this is are what's called elements. So if you click new element at the top here, you can see all of these different elements. Now, every element has a specific purpose. So for example, you can see this landing page is very simple. You know, I have the first thing is just when they come to it, they know what this is for. I'm promoting again, Cabos. And I just have a picture, you know, just to be like, wow, that's beautiful. The second element I added in here was just, you know, a photo, which it looks squashed right now because of the format I'm in, cause I'm editing it. But then I have, just a resort that I'm highlighting. You know, I could say that Barcelo Grand is my favorite resort. I am just promoting it. So I just went ahead and I, you know, grabbed a photo and then I just put some text in here. So really, really simple. Another thing though, that I want to add is I want to add some photos. You know, I really want to sell this place. So again, I just added some photos. You can add like an image carousel, you know, in here. And again, these are just all elements and you don't have to do it this way, but it's just so simple, in there. Now the other thing, is I also put maybe like a quick thing about activities you can do in there, you know, all that fun stuff. But I want to add a couple things here together. So again, this is a really high level overview of a landing page. So we do have more stuff that shows you how to add this. In fact, I want to share a video here. So the anatomy of a landing page was a video we did probably like less than a year ago. But I'm going to drop this link. This YouTube link right there is actually going to walk you through more of this in depth. I highly recommend it. It is my favorite webinar we've ever done. So it's really cool. But what I want to add is I want to add two things here together. The first thing that I want to add is I want to import an itinerary, like a sample itinerary. So when somebody comes to this landing page, they can get an idea of what a trip could look like that I could book them. So what you can do is you're actually able to add a new element here. And I'm going to come down and I'm going to add the element of trip gallery. So again, here's the beauty of working with a website or landing page in Travefy. We're actually going to be able to pull trips that you've created in Travefy. So you can just drag and drop this trip gallery in. Now I have these cards. These are called cards. And I can add, you know, three different trips. So if you ever want to advertise, you know, different itinerary examples, things like that, you could do that. You can have an endless amount of cards in here. But I'm actually going to delete two of these because I just want one. And what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to click this pencil icon in here. And you could fill this out if you wanted, but there's something even easier here that we can do. So I am just going to click this import from Travefy at the bottom here. I'm importing a trip. Now I made this already. So I am going to just go ahead and see this Los Cabos trip example. That's what I made before this. So I'm just going to add that one in. And look, it adds everything for me. So I could always come in and I can start adding things. Like if I want to add like, here, let's see, starting at, you know, 2000 or whatever you want to put, you could, or if there's like a date or something, you can put that in there, but, really great. So you can control what this is going to say and look like. But otherwise, you know, I'm just going to go ahead and save that there. And then I'm going to publish it. So that way we can, see what it looks like. So watch what I just did. So I'm going to click preview at the top here. And then I'm going to scroll so you can see here's what we just added. I'm going to click view trip. Check this out. So obviously I have nothing in here yet because we're going to add that later. You can see here that it just looks like a normal trip, except for at the top, do you notice how it's a little different? It says contact. So this is a marketing trip instead of your typical where it would say like the app, download the app, get the PDF. It's not like that. It's actually all trying to market something and then them reaching out to you. So Really awesome. And I did see a question here about how do I do that for like cruises? You would just create an itinerary with the cruise in it and then import it in. All you do. So, so easy. So I love that. It's so cool. The other thing that's really important when you're creating a landing page for marketing is collecting those leads. So if we go back here to this little deck, we have, okay, we created the landing page, but now we actually need to capture leads. So how are we going to do that? We're going to do that with a form. So when somebody comes on here and they're like, this is awesome, I want to know what is the next step, how do I sign up? Down at the bottom, I added the element, which is called call to action. So it's called a call to action element. So it's the last thing. It's like, okay, here's the next step. Click this button, fill out this form, and then I'll contact you. So how you can do this, and if you're familiar, in Travefy, you can create forms. So you can create a form to collect any type of information you need, whether it's, you know, new traveler info, just a basic travel, like the, what I'm going to create is just a really basic traveler, all those kinds of stuff. So to do that, I just came in here. I'm going to add a button, which you can add a button at any place within this landing page as well. But I'm just going to say add button. Now I can say, what is the button? Where's it going? And there's different options you can have, but I want this to sync to a form. So I'm going to click form. Now what's going to happen is I can either import a new or import a form from Travefy that I've already created. So you might go ahead and just create that in there. But you also can start creating a form right in this page. And I love that because you don't have to go out and then come back in. It's very easy. So you can just start creating a form right in here. Now, if you're not as familiar with creating forms, it's so simple. I'm just going to say Los Cabos example form on website. I'm just going to type it in this way. But what you can do is you can say add new, add your question, really easy, you know, so we can just say, what is your name? And then you can add additional text. You can say like, as shown on your passport or whatever it might be. Someone just said, you're blowing my mind. I know, it's so great. You don't have to go out and do another thing. It's so awesome. And here's a tip, here's a pro tip right here, is when you're choosing what type of response you're looking for, you can obviously say, is it short answer, long answer, multiple choice, but these smart fields right here, I would recommend using this if it makes sense, because this is going to sync with your contacts. So I'm going to show you after this, once we get a new lead, what I do with it. And if you choose a smart field, it makes it a little easy for you to push this over into the contact. So I'm just going to say, okay, I want just contact name. It's going to be required. And then I can save that. And then of course, you know, anything you need to add, what are your dates of travel? Will you be needing airfare? You know, all that kind of stuff in there. Another thing too, that you can always put text. So if you don't have necessarily a question to ask, maybe it's at the beginning of the form and you just want to put like a photo and some information about, you know, if you fill out this form, I'll contact you, blah, blah, blah. You know, so you do have that flexibility to add something like that. But that's all you do. So it's really easy. And then you just click done and then it's in there. Now I'm actually going to import this other one here though, cause I had more questions on it. And then I can, also customize this button. So I'm going to say, start planning your trip, and then I'm gonna click save. Okay. Now watch this. This is so cool. This is like seriously really, really awesome. Cause when you preview this, this is what they're seeing. By the way, they can view this on any device. So if it's mobile, tablet, computer, it'll always, you know, be scaled to fit. But if we come down here, here's that button that we just created. Look at this. This will stay in the same screen so they can go ahead, fill out all this information right here. Very easy. And then that's it. And then they can go ahead and submit it. And then what happens once they submit it is you will get an email letting you know that someone has submitted a form, and then you can come in Travefy and view or retrieve that response and view it. Now what it looks like when you do that, we're going to come out here now. So I'm actually going to move into this form. So we talked about the forms, but now I want to go and start seeing how to retrieve this contact and start to organize it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to exit this here, and I'm going to go back. I'm going to go back into my main account. Now, your forms are always living in the library. So if you click the library here, this is where they live. So if you ever want to create a form in here first, you can just say new library item and choose form. So you can do that. So like, here's that form that I just created, when in that pop-up. But this one right here is actually the one that, I had somebody fill out pretend before, so that way you could see it. So I got an email notification letting me know someone filled it out. So then I can come in here and I can see all the responses. Now, this one right here is my new one. So this person just submitted their information and now I have all their information in here. So now it's time for me to start reaching out to them being like, hey, thanks for your interest. Like, I'd love to get set up a call, whatever it might be, whatever your next step might be. But one thing that's really great is you can click assign to new contact because this is a new lead and then see how it automatically knows that name, the email. So I'm going to say create and assign. So now this contact's here. And now this is living in my contacts. So when you log into your account again, how I got here is you click contacts at the top. And then now you can see it. So here's that new person right here. So you can see this person right in here. And so it automatically pulled in their details that they filled out. And now here's where I can come in and start adding more information. Now I have one. I'm actually going to go to a different contact that's more filled out so you can see like more what's possible here. But I had this person before where you can come in and I just filled out more stuff. So there's a lot of things you can do in the contacts field. You know, of course you have the details, the main stuff, their email, phone, but you also can create your own custom fields. So a lot of the times we hear users where you might want like an anniversary date or, you know, whatever other things that you might want. And that's where you can actually come in here and you can click manage custom fields and then just start adding your own field. So whatever information you need to capture, just create a field for it. And then it'll live on every contact. So you don't have to do that for every contact, which is great. So you can have that in there. And then you can also, you know, put a description. So if there's anything, maybe you get on a call with them and you just want to add, maybe this is the main person who's going to be planning the trip. So you're working with Lucy the most, things like that. You also can add labels. So this is really handy. If you're working with a group, if you're ever working with like a group trip or destination wedding or family, and you just want to put a label so you can connect multiple contacts and easily find everybody at once. Great way to do that. And then you can also add notes. So I added a couple here. So, you know, if you set up a call, consultation call, you start putting your notes in here, things like that. You can also see what trips they're part of. So once I do send a proposal on the next step, that proposal will actually start attaching to this contact so I can easily go back and see everything. Same with the form. So this person filled out that form. So it's always going to live right here as well. So I can, again, easily access that in there. And then another really big one, this has been a huge one, is being able to save documents. So once you do start working with this person, you're like, can you send me passport information, whatever it might be? You can do that because this is safe and secure. I'll talk about it here in a little bit when we talk about credit card authorization, but there is an extra level of password protection when using this documentation or this docs area for that reason, because we know you might be actually keeping some sensitive information in there. And then you know that it is safe and secure, which is at the end of the day, the best thing. So that's all those things, you know, really, really awesome. Now, here's another huge pro tip. This is something that we added just months ago, is tasks. I cannot stress how amazing tasks is, especially during the sales process workflow. Because with this task, let's say this Sandra Smith, this is a brand new person. So maybe it's, you know, Sunday night. So I don't really want to contact this person right now, but I will first thing tomorrow. So what I'll do is I'm going to type a task here and I'm going to say, schedule consultation call. And then I'm going to go ahead and just add this for, we'll pretend it's the 20th. I can also add a time. So if I want to say, you know, I don't want to make it too early. So I'm just going to do 10 a.m. And then now I'm going to get notified and I have a task here to follow up with this person. And then maybe I have follow up with Sandra, like if I haven't heard back. So maybe I'll go ahead and just put that as like the next day. So that way I have this automatic, like, okay, I need to follow up with this person in there. This is so, so cool. The other thing you can do is you can create these tasks in a contact field, but you can also see all of your tasks at the top here. So there's like that little clipboard. And if something's due on that day, it'll actually have like a red notification symbol trying to get your attention, but you can see all of your tasks. So you can also add tasks in here. So if you do have a task that doesn't have to do with a contact, you can put that in here too. So really awesome. I just love that. Really, really cool in there. But okay, so I'm going to go back to this flow. So let's recap here. We have made a marketing, we've marketed, Los Cabos. So we made a landing page. I ended up capturing information by including the form. So now I have this new lead. I put them in my contacts and I set up a consultation call with them. And now I know that where they want to go, what they want to do. So now it's for the fun part, is proposal. So now I want to send them a proposal and be like, okay, I've got all your information. So I'm going to send you some ideas here. So what I'm going to do is I am going to go to trips. So I'm going to come in here and I am going to actually jump in here. So normally you would click new trip and you would choose proposal. The difference with the proposal, so this right here, I need to set that as a proposal. You'll know it's a proposal because of this badge. Now, I say this in the other webinar sessions, but it really doesn't matter which one you click because they look the same in the itinerary builder. And before you send it, you can always make sure it's the right type. So see how I changed this? You can always switch it back and forth, which is really good. So if you accidentally create it as an itinerary, you don't have to redo it. You just change the type as proposal. And the proposal is actually allowing them to approve it, where when it's an itinerary, they can get the app and all that stuff, which you'll see at the end here, what the difference will look like. But I'm going to hop into this really quick. I'm just going to go in here. Now I already started building this, you know, I added photo, just the Los Cabos trip example. I changed the stay title, by the way. I did that just by clicking, the edit button for the day. And I'm just putting resort option because I don't actually know the dates that this client might travel. So I'm just giving them like some basic resort information right now. So that's what I'm doing. So let's add that resort here now. So I'm going to add that resort by clicking the new event button and I'm going to choose lodging. So from here, what I'm going to do is I am going to type in the Barcelo, Grand. And this is one that I was promoting on the landing page. So that worked for this person. So I'm just going to go ahead and choose this option here. Now you can see here, all this information pops in. Really handy. Travefy has a database just of information where it's pulling photos, address. This can all be customized though, of course, but it's just so handy having that in there. And I'm just going to add this. So I'm keeping it really simple, just this one event here. But now this is not going to sell it, right? We need to add more. So we're going to add some information super easily. Just click this pencil icon right here. And I'm actually going to just remove that out. I'm just going to say just the name resort option. So you can customize all this, which is nice. And then I actually went ahead and before, I just copy and pasted some information from the website. But this is a great place if you do want to add information and be like, this is why I would recommend it. Like we were talking about how you really like this and this has a great option for that. Great spot to do that. There's also a lot of formatting you can do in here. So if you ever want to add links, you can do that. You can add tables, which is really handy when you're doing quotes and proposals, because we could say like suite will be, you know, 3,000, 3,400. And then maybe like swim up will be 4,500 or whatever it might be. So you can break it down. That's what's really cool. And you can, again, do formatting, all kinds of stuff. So I love that. I think that's just kind of a really simple game changer that really shows them, you know, organizing things. So you can do all that. You can also, of course, just add the price in here. So if you want to add the pricing, if it's like one set price, you can do that as well. And you can just quickly do that. And then again, how those tables you add those is you are just going to click this table option. So it's like that little, it almost looks like a little calendar up there, but that's a table. So table icon, you can do that. Okay, so now my personal favorite thing, if you've been on a webinar before, you know, we do not shy away from this because this is what is going to sell this place is adding multimedia. So adding photos or videos. So how you do that, come in this multimedia section. This will appear on every event you add and you can just click in here. Now we do have free stock photos. We have thousands of free stock photos you can search for. But if you have your own photos, you can always upload them yourself. But we can also pull from a website. Now I went and grabbed this earlier, but this is the website to this resort. And I'm just dropping it in here and grabbing photos. So Travefy can go out and look for photos and pull them in if we see them. And so you can see here, found lots of photos. Sometimes you might have like 100 in there. It's pretty awesome. And then you can go ahead and you can choose up to 5 images in here. You can say, okay, I want to show some room pics, you know, in there. But I'm only going to choose 4. Because I'm also going to add a video, which I love doing this. I think this is one of the easiest way to really bring this proposal to life by adding a video, which you can just click the video option here. And it's so simple. You actually are just going to copy and paste the YouTube or Vimeo. So if it's like YouTube or Vimeo, just copy and paste it in. And then that's all you do. And so now I have, I'm going to drag and drop this to the front here. I'll show you what this looks like for the client, but this video now is in here. And I highly recommend this because a lot of times the resorts or check out like the destination organizations or the tourism organizations for that destination typically have these amazing videos that you can just share. You know, it's already their public. They spend millions of dollars making these videos sometimes. So why not use them, you know? Or if you have your own, a lot of times, sometimes people might have their own videos and you can share those in here too. But it's just so cool. It really, really brings us to life in here. Now I'm just going to click done. And there we go. There we go. You know, you can see, just quickly added some information here. One pro tip I want to throw in here, because especially when you're working with like destinations like this, where you have resorts, you can save this information to your library. So you don't have to recreate this every time. Especially since I'm already promoting a specific place. It's very helpful if I just have it in my library and I can quickly pop it in when I'm building a new itinerary proposal. And your library is just living over here on the right-hand side. So it's just going to be what you personally save to your library. So yours won't look like mine. It'll be personalized to what you need. But this right here that I just created, if I wanted to save it to my library, all I would do is just click these little 3 dots there and click save to library. That simple. And of course, maybe when you save it, maybe remove out pricing information, because then when you do add this to a new proposal, then you can add in the pricing and the room options that they are interested in. So highly, highly recommend that. It's really awesome. And again, you'll see tomorrow, Scott's going to be doing just ways to maximize that library. So it's pretty awesome. Really great way. Now, okay, I want to add one more thing here together, and then we're going to go through the process of what this, the workflow that the client sees to approve this proposal. So the last thing that I want to add in here, though, is I want to add some destination content, because we have what's called city guides built directly into your Travefy account that you can just go ahead and grab and drag and drop in. It's really easy. I'm going to click really quick though in this information document section. So this at the top, you can always use this. And this is a great place to put like insurance information or emergency contacts or really just anything that has to do with the whole trip instead of like a certain day. But in here, if you come over to your right-hand side and you can look at city guides. So you click on city guides and then you type in the name of a city. And then, okay, so for this example, I want Los Cabos. So I'm just going to type in Cabos, click that. And now what I can do is I can drag and drop this entire city guide in, which I'm adding the whole city guide. You do not have to add all of it because it is actually a lot of information, which is really great, but sometimes you might not need that much. But check this out. Look at all of this stuff. You know, you have information about the city, you have things to do and see, you have dining, you know, you really can pick and choose what you want. So if you don't want like the do and see, or you want to edit it, you can do that. You know, you can remove it. You can add your own, it's really awesome. You can also build your own city guides if you ever want to do that, just by clicking the new information item, and then you can create your own guide and of course save that to your library so that way you can reuse it. But so easy, so easy. But look at this. This was a really simple proposal. So if I just click preview, you can see this is what it's going to look like. You know, I have the resort. I have a couple different options for them. Here's that video. I have to show you this because look at this. It just stays in the same screen, which is incredible. And then they can also look at those pictures that we added as well. All that good stuff. There's also over here a little chat. So on the right-hand side here, you can chat with them. So if you're like, you know, you want to say, hey, check this out. Like, look at all these options. Or maybe they're like, oh, we're thinking about doing the swim up. You know, can you change the pricing to match what we're thinking now? You know, you can do all that. And you don't have to resend it. It updates automatically. So it's a real-time thing, which is super cool. So using that trip chat is awesome in the proposal stage. But what they will do when they are approving this is they literally just click the approve button. It's very easy. They click this, they'll put in their name and email. And then what's going to happen is they receive an email, just confirming that they approved it. And then, they'll have a PDF copy of what they approved. And then you'll get the same thing. You'll get an email letting you know, and then, you will be able to come in here and look at that. It says approved now. How exciting. So it says approved now, but you'll see it still is here. So I can come back. And if I ever need to go back and look at what was approved, I can, but this automatically converted itself into an itinerary. So the great thing is now I can just start editing the same trip without having to recreate anything and send them a new link. Really easy. But before I convert this into that actual confirmed itinerary, one more thing that I want to do is I want to talk about the credit card authorization. So typically, you know, once they confirm it, you might be like, okay, cool. I just need a deposit or whatever it might be to send to the supplier. So to create that credit card authorization form, you just need to go into your library here, and then, you can create either a new form, or maybe you already have a form created for credit card authorization, but you can just say, new form. And then, I'm just going to put CC auth. And then you'll say add new, and you're going to add a question here. We also do have a template. So you could have clicked that template. Let me go back, because that might actually be the easiest thing to do. So you can say create from template, and then there's a credit card authorization in here. So right there. But what you would do is if you're creating it yourself, you would just click on this. And one of the options is a card authorization. Now, this is very important. If you don't see card authorization listed, that means that you have not turned on two-factor authentication. So like I was talking about earlier with the documents and saving that kind of information, you do have to have two-factor authentication turned on, which is really easy to do. You just go into your account settings and then turn it on. And basically, it's like if you're familiar with your online banking or where they might send you, you know, some numbers with on a text message, and you just have to reconfirm it. It's just like a double password protection. That's all you do. So it's easy. Set it up, and then you'll see this option here, and then you'll be able to say, you know, what is your payment information, or however you want to word it. Also, you can require CVV or not. So pay attention to that if you do need it. And then when you send it, you will have to send it directly via email. So you will have to say email to clients. So this isn't like if it's another type of form. Usually if it's like new traveler inquiry, you can just grab a link, send it to them. But this one does require you to send it directly to them because, again, security. So put in their email. You will need to put the authorization description so that way they see what they're authorizing. You also have to put in that amount. And then pay attention to this part as well, because the authorization deadline will expire. So by April 13th, if I keep it at that, that means that after this date, their card will automatically be deleted. And so if I needed it again, I would have to ask them for the authorization again. So pay attention to that, to note like, okay, I will need it, you know, in, you know, whatever this day might be. So that way you have it. But then once they fill this out, they'll just add their card information, and it'll be treated like any other form where once they fill it out, they will, you'll get an email reply letting you know they filled it out and you can go view it. But then the good thing is they also get an email, a PDF copy of the authorization that they did. So they'll see the last four digits of the card they added. They'll see what time they did, all that good stuff. So I love that because it's just, again, it's just safe and secure, and we're PCI compliant. So you really can't get any more safe and secure than that. So it's really nice knowing that you are doing everything right. You know, because sensitive information. But then when you are ready to go get their information, all you do is you're actually just going to come in here. What was the one I had? Right here. So if you click on forms, you view response, and then you'll see their card information in here, and then you'll click view details and check this out. I haven't signed back in for a while. So it's just telling me sign back in. Security again. And then you'll be able to see this, and you will just click view card number. You'll be able to see it. And then that CVV as well. So that's really what you'll do. Very easy. Once again, it's what we aim to do is make this easy for you. But okay. So the last thing, we're on our last step, and then we're going to get to Q&A here. So the last step is the final itinerary. So let's say, you know, we have all the money, they are ready. So we're going to go in here and, you know, there's not a lot we need to really change. I might change this, and I'm going to actually put a date now. So let's just say the date is March 23rd here. So we're just going to say, okay, maybe I'll add a flight. So I'm going to say new event. I'm going to add a flight here. If you've never seen this before, prepare to get your mind blown because it's awesome. You can just type in the airline and then the flight number. That's all you do. And then you click add to itinerary. Check this out. Well, also let me edit this. I need to drag and drop because they will not be checking in first. That's the last. So let me just change that. All right. Check this out. So we have their flight in here now, and see how there's that little green check mark there. That means that we are tracking this. So now when your clients are viewing this trip, they will see the updated time. If it gets delayed, gate changes, all that stuff, it'll be updated in here. But they can also download that app. So that app they download just by clicking the app button here. And I actually have this right here. This website we actually created for you to share with your clients. So I'm going to put that. Someone said, love that feature. I know. It's so awesome. So this is so cool. So you can be able to come in here. And again, you can share this with your clients. It's going to show them like why they should download it and how. Super easy, but just shows them how to do it. But then in here, they'll be able to view all their stuff on the go. They'll see those automatic flight updates. They also can chat with you. So you can chat with them. If you attach any documents, they can access them from here. Tons of stuff. So it's really, really awesome. So that is, you know, taking them all the way through. And then of course, you know, once they get back, we do have the option for you to turn on a trip feedback form. So then that way, you know, if they want to give you like a review or something, you know, and that might be the final step to everything. So that takes you through the entire sales workflow. I know that was probably a lot there. So I'm glad that I have time for questions here. So Bonnie, okay, Bonnie's in the background here working hard. I can see an alum in there answering all those questions. Bonnie, what questions do we have here? What are some big ones that are coming in?
Oh boy, we have a lot of questions. So I will say, so sorry if we can't get to all of them. We are doing our best. But of course, if you don't have any that get answered, just email us at professional@travefy.com, and we can also link some articles as well. But a few that I saw came in that I think are pretty good ones are, let me go find the one that I wanted to ask you. This is kind of taking us back just a little bit,
But can you define landing page versus website? There were some questions about that, if it's the same thing. Can you just define it?
Yeah, it's such a good question because it does get really confusing because, especially because we call it a website builder. But basically the difference is if you have a website, that might be like your main page. So like your website might have a couple things in it, like, you know, here are the services, here's the destinations I, you know, book for, whatever it might be. So it's like a good way to explain it. Let's say my website's travelistastravel.com. That's my main website. But let's say that I'm promoting, well, I did the Los Cabos, but let me use this one. So I'm promoting a river cruise. I'm trying to, you know, fill up 20 cabins on this river cruise. So I created a landing page for it. And so the landing page is travelistastravel.com/2023-river-cruise. And so now with that link, I could put it on my website if I wanted, but now that link, I can just send somebody right there and they're just going to one page that has all the information they need. So it's really a one pager. So hopefully that makes sense there, but, I would recommend again on Thursday, we'll do the website one, but then the Facebook Live that Bonnie did yesterday is on landing page. And that might kind of help you think about the ways to use it, but it's so cool. I love the landing page option there.
Perfect. And I'm actually going to have you stay in here. There was one question that came up that I wanted to make sure you went over because I realized some people might not know how to do this. But is there a way to make a copy of one of your landing pages that you already made?
Yes. Oh my God. Yes. That's one of the coolest things because you'll find everybody listening. I swear you are going to start making these and love them and want to keep copying them. So, cause you can build like a template for yourself. So build a template. And then whenever you have a landing page right in here and when you're in the main settings, there's that save button, but it's kind of hidden here, but it's that little, I don't even know what that'd be, like two papers, like on top of each other, because it's a copy. You just click that and it copies the whole page. It's pretty great.
Awesome. And it's super handy too, especially if you add buttons to either your navigation bar or to the footer, where it's just standard throughout your entire website or landing pages, where you don't have to relink them. You don't have to do all of that work. It just cuts a lot of it out.
Yeah.
But love it's awesome. That feature.
Jill just said it's a duplicate button.
Yes, exactly.
Thank you, Jill. That. Yes.
Oh my gosh.
I was like, that's a copy, it's a paper. It's a duplicate button. Thank you.
That duplicate button. So a nice little thing that hides out. But I have another question that came up a little bit in the chat and the Q&A area, but how can people get to your landing page? How can you share this out with the world and how would you share this out?
Yeah, it's a good question. So there's a lot of ways. I think probably one of the biggest is probably social media. So like if you have this landing page, so actually, let me do something here. Let me share this landing page. The landing page that I just built, I just shared that in the chat, but that link, I could put that anywhere. I mean, I could link it onto my website. I could put like a button in there and then you just link it to an external link, which goes there. I could put it on, again, social media, really anywhere that you can add a link, that's where you can put it.
Perfect. And then this one, I thought we might as well highlight since we are just going through the landing page a little bit before we hop over to some of those other questions back in the trip area. But can you show us how to change the colors on a landing page?
Yeah, because I actually didn't go through that. So basically what you can always do is when you're in the settings, you can change the theme. So you can always switch this around. So you can do like different things, but you can also change that theme color. So that's how you would do that. So you can start branding it more to you. So that's important to highlight that if this looks more like your branding and then you can change the color, then you can do that.
Perfect. Yes. That's always a fun area to customize and you can always go back if you need to. So really there's nothing that you can do in the website builder that will break it. So super, super handy. But next we're going to hop back out of the landing page. And this question is kind of goes with contacts and tasks. So how can you get notified when a task is due and how are you notified?
Yeah. Oh, that's good because there's two ways. So one, when you log into your account, you'll see that there's stuff due. Like there'll be like a little red icon thing there. And you can see like what's due today. But the biggest one is download the Travefy Pro app. So I didn't talk about that. So the trip plans app that I was talking about, that is for the client to view, but you actually have your own app, which is called Travefy Pro. So if you don't have that, go download that and you just log in with your Travefy credentials. And then you can actually view your tasks and get notified in there. You can add them in there. So those are the two ways that you'd be getting notified in there.
Perfect. That answers it. And then a couple more that I saw that I think would be fun to go through is, how did you create the payment table in your contact area?
Yeah, I know. That is a cool. I took that one from Scott. I was like, that's a good idea. So what you do is it's in the notes. So click on the notes. And then if you click more here, there's an insert table option. So that's how you can do that.
Perfect. And yes, that feature, we have that available in the trips as well. So whenever mm-hmm. you see that, that's when you know you can make a table. Forms as well too. I'm not sure if people realize you can do it in forms. So it can be super handy just to lay out the information in a little bit of a different way. But awesome. And speaking of forms, how do we get responses for forms? Where do we find responses? Do they go to contacts? Do they go somewhere mm-hmm. else? How are we notified with that?
Yeah. So you'll get an email. So you will get an email letting you know that a form has been filled out. And then you can just go, you can follow that link from that email into your Travefy account. Or if you just come in here, you can also see, so like if I go back here, you can click on responses and see everything in here. So that's what's really nice. If you have like, so let's say Sandra Smith fills out another form. I don't have to come in and push it over to her because if they're using the same email address, it actually will link up into the contact. But when we're talking about new leads, like we were saying today, that's when you'll start see them come in here and then you can do what you need with them. But otherwise, once they become like a client that you're already working with, it'll start just going into that contact, but you still get notified. You'll still know when something's coming through, so you won't miss it.
Great. Awesome. And then, you know, speaking of just being in the library in general, do you want to take a little bit of time just to show how to create a task list if you want to? Because that just goes along with, you know, making sure you're on top of things.
I know. I love this one. This is really cool. So in there, so if you go, okay. And so what a task list is basically the difference, a task list can go onto a trip. So right here, so you can see whenever I'm in a trip here, there's a task little area right here. So I can create them one off right here, but you can actually import task lists. So I can import one like, okay, once it's confirmed, here's my booking list. So I have like collect deposit, send traveler form. Now, how I created that is in the library by saying new library item, task list. Now what I can do is let's say this is a pre-trip task list. And then you can just, again, however you need to do this, and then you can add tasks. And here's one thing that's super cool is you can say, okay, collect deposits. We'll say that. Now the due date is always going to be different because you don't know the date of this trip. So what you can say is you're like, all right, I need to always have that deposit, like let's say 100 days before that trip start date. So you can choose, is it a trip end date, start date? You can add a note. So maybe this reminds you like, here's what I need to actually get in this, what the task means. And that's all you do. So you just say, okay, done. And then now what it'll do is what you'll get. Oh, actually, let me add one more here because I want to show you what this will be like. So I'm going to add one more. I'm going to say, ask for review. And we're going to do this. Let's say it's 5 days after trip end date. So we're going to do
it. The part.
Yeah.
I love this part.
I know. It's so cool because watch what happens. So now I have that pre-trip. And so let's add it in here. So if I go into task, so import task list, here's that one I just created. Look at this. It automatically knows those dates. So it adds it in there for me. So like, that's outdated, but this one still, you can see it's green. So it still is 5. It's not due until March 28th. So that's what's really cool. So, and you can also, if you're ever working like in a team, you can assign them to different owners too, which is really cool. So if you're like going to be out of the office and you need someone else to take care of it for you, you can assign that to them so that they get notified. So really awesome there. Love it. So
great.
Cool.
No, and see, these are features again that sometimes don't pop out at you until you just actually realize, oh, what are these buttons here for? And you just start clicking into them. But awesome. Great. I know we're running up on our time, so I'm finding a few more in here. But one other one, we're kind of going back to the landing page. The landing page, it feels almost like a whole nother product in itself. But can you just show us quick how, if we have two landing pages, how we can connect them together?
Yeah. So what you would do, there's a couple ways. So usually I feel like the most common is up at the top, that little toolbar up here, or the navigation bar that we call it. And all you would do, so let's say that this is the toolbar up here, the nav bar. All you do is just click onto it. So you'll just click into that element. Then on the right-hand side is where you edit it. And then you'll just click add item. And then you can choose, like, is this a button? Is this a link? So let's just make a link here. And then I can choose, is this going to a different page section? Is this going to a whole different page or an external link? You know, you can put in your own URL, but I can also link this to another page. So let's say that Los Cabos vacation. So I'm just going to say now booking. Oh gosh, I can't type there. Los Cabos. So I'm just going to say that. This doesn't, you can make this look a lot prettier than I just did now, but check this out. So when I preview it, now when I say now booking, it just goes directly into that page. So then on this page, you could do the same thing where you have that navigation bar and you're linking it back to your website or something. So that's how you can do that, you know, different ways. And of course, you can also, you don't have to use the nav bar. You can also add a button at the top here or, you know, right here. So you can add a button anywhere in there.
Mm-hmm. And buttons really are going to make life so much easier. And it actually makes the website page actually functional, because you can link it to external links. So if you have another website, I've been seeing that a lot where people are asking how can I link my current website to some of these landing pages and vice versa? Those buttons are going to be your best friend. You would just want to make sure the button is set to an external link, and then, you know, grab your link from your main website, put it in there. That way clients can go back and forth really easily. And of course, too, I know we only have so much time. Feel free to reach out to us at professional@travefy.com. That's a pretty common question, and we can get you answered there really easily. But awesome. I think the last one that I have is when you we're in your credit card authorization form, is there a way that we can put our own terms and conditions in there instead?
Yeah, absolutely. So you can put in your own, you can do this. So, okay. Like, let's say we have the credit card authorization. I'm just going to type randomly here. And then right down here. So this electronic signature, or right here, you can, this will actually has to be turned on when you're doing, a credit card authorization, but you can copy and paste your own terms and conditions right here. So a good point to bring up here is that let's say you only want this to be a waiver. Like it's not, you're not really getting a credit card authorization. You're just doing your own like cancellation policy or something like that. So you can always include this section right here without the credit card authorization too, which is, I think is really cool. So yeah, just drop in your terms and conditions right here. And then what I would recommend when you do that, so you don't have to do this every time, just always work out of the same form, or you can always copy this. You can copy forms as well. So that way, if you need to specialize, but that's a good idea if you are doing the terms and conditions, so you don't have to copy and paste that every time.
Yes. Awesome. Thank you so much. Yeah. And thank you everyone too, again, for taking time out of your day to join us this week. One thing that I am going to throw into the chat is the library gallery page, just because we were talking about forms, talking about templates in general. If you go to that link that I just sent in the chat, some of you may have been here before, but that is where a lot of Travefy users have actually let us put some of their content on there that you can save directly to your account, including quite a few forms that you can customize. It'll have your information on there instead of theirs. So it's a super handy resource to check out if, again, you haven't already.
Yeah, that thing is a game changer. It's so awesome. So yeah, definitely check that out. And I just want to say again too, thank you so, so much. I know this was a lot. So definitely know we are here to help. But also our next session that is coming up at 2 p.m. Central is with Kendra and Bonnie. Well, you'll see Bonnie's face again. yes, it's going to be awesome. And it's creating all-inclusive proposal and itinerary. So almost kind of what I just did, but way more intense. Depth onto this, the all-inclusive side, and just talking about proposals and itineraries. So join us for that. But again, thank you so, so much. And thanks Bonnie and Ellen for answering. Again, I know there's questions that are really hard to get all answered. So do reach out to our support team. They are ready to go behind the scenes after all these webinars. So definitely hit us up. We can help.
Awesome. Bye, everybody.
See ya very soon again. See ya.